So let's start with next Magha Nakshatra. And in the last 9 Nakshatras, we have been covering the mantras, stories, remedies, and the result of different padas, right? We'll go with the same order in this video as well. Also, one more thing, you people may remember that Asalesha was a Gandhant. And while discussing Asalesha, we also discussed that Magha is also a Gandhant. So once again, the first pada of Magha is very bad. The second pada is less bad. Third pada is even less bad. And the fourth pada is very less bad, right? So this is something that needs to be kept into consideration while doing this, right? There are 2-3 things that you need to understand before we proceed further. This is a part of an extensive course. So many of the things related to the nakshatras I'm not covering. I'm just covering a few part of it. Right? I'm just covering a few parts of it. I was saying that it is a part of a long course, right? And there are 2 approaches to go with something. The knowledge of nakshatra is not limited. It is very extensive. And I cannot give you that extensive knowledge in one video. If I try to give it, that video will be extremely long, 10 hours, 12 hours, right? So I have segregated the knowledge of nakshatra that I want to teach, right? And in this particular section, we are just dealing with the mantra stories. That's all. Mantra stories and the result as per the Navamsha. There are separate results for the padas of nakshatra given in classics also that I am not covering. Are you able to understand me what I am saying? Right? So understand that it is a very extensive thing and I am only telling a part of it. Right? So those who are watching this particular video on YouTube, don't come with this complaint that, sir, you have left this, you have left that. No, sir, I haven't left anything. Okay. Sir, I have included everything, but that is in the course. Okay. That point one, important. Keep this in mind while we are learning this particular stuff. Okay. That's point one. Point two. First is, you know, the extensiveness, right? The thing is very extensive. There are multiple facets of it. There are multiple aspects of it. Right? And in the course, I have covered it using multiple aspects. Right now, I am not telling you the result of nakshatra padas as given in classics. But in the course, we will cover that, right? So that is one of the things. Another thing is, you know, like up to this extent, people have been misguided, right? But you are at a good place now. I don't believe in misguiding people. Getting my point? I don't believe in misguiding people. For an example, you know, the result of this nakshatra gives you this, that nakshatra gives you that. Whenever you read something, ask yourself a question that can you predict anything using this particular knowledge? Right? Like the, for one particular nakshatra, for Pushya nakshatra, the person will talk on mobile while working. That is very good. Okay. And you may know it and you may be amazed that, oh, sir, while I am watching the video, I am talking on phone only. You can watch video only on your phone or your computer, other things that you cannot do, by the way. You are not Sanjay from Mahabharat, but still. Right. But, you know, generally, and I want to give you about this particular knowledge, generally what happens, we become fascinated by such things. The people who are watching this video will be wearing yellow color or red color dress, or will have something yellow or red in their room. In every room, there is at least one thing that is yellow or red, by the way. How many colors do you know? Very few. Even for males, male can only understand 12, 13 colors, not more than that. Woman can understand better in this particular regard, right? So this is something that is very fascinating. This is something that is very fascinating, that this particular room, this particular color is in the room, or the person of this nakshatra talks a lot on phone, etc. But what predictions you can make out of it? And it is not like that you want to become an astrologer. That's not the prime objective at all. Even if you are not going to become an astrologer, that too. If you are able to predict something, even for yourself, only in that scenario you will be able to avoid that particular thing, right? So this knowledge that you will be talking over phone, or you will do things in a repetitive manner, you know what? My guru in education, my best teacher, told me one particular thing, that you know, in human mind, there is a limited space for knowledge. So make sure that you only fill that much that is essential. And don't fill a whole lot of information. Getting around, we are starting with the video. We will start with the video, but you have to patiently listen to what I'm saying. Because that is something important. Getting around, you have to understand this particular thing. It is very important to take the gems and leave other things out. Getting my point? Many, many people who come to me. By the way, recently I have crossed 1,000 student mark. So by this time, I have taught more than 1,000 students in my career. And you know, many of the people come across a block that they have learned something that is unnecessary and now they cannot get rid of it. Whenever I tell you that seventh lord, if the seventh lord is in the third house, then dharma of the marriage is problem. Marital life is good until and unless one of the spouse cheats. Once the cheating will happen, there will be no way to save the marriage. This is something that I will teach you. But if you are already conditioned with some other information, whenever you will look at a chart, because you know, such things attract more. Bad things always attract more, right? Habit of reading Hanuman Chalisa daily will not come. But habit of drinking alcohol daily will come, and 60-40 tends to happen. Bad things attract, right? You know what is the stumbling block that they come across? When I give them the chart and I tell them for prediction, and they are not able to predict it, I will ask them that I taught you this particular rule. Why you are not predicting using this rule? And they will tell me that, sir, this rule came to my mind. That first one, like your wife is talking over phone type of result. Getting my point? So having your mind clear, having your thought clear is very essential and important. Getting my point? And at the end of the day, whatever information you take, be like, if you are going to purchase something in a market, you judge the value of the stuff, whether it is important for me or not. Will I be able to use it or not, right? Will you spend 10,000 rupees on something that is going to be of no use? Suppose you don't have a dog. Will you spend 1,000 rupees purchasing pedigree? Who will eat pedigree? You will eat pedigree. You don't have a dog, pedigree is of no use to you, right? You know what? If you spend 10,000 rupees on something that you don't need, you know what? 10,000 rupees will come again. But if you spend 20 minutes of your life doing something that is of no use, my friend, that 20 minute will never come. That 20 minute will never ever come. This is what my teacher told me. To use your mind, to use your time on something that is constructive, that is useful. Not on something that is not constructive, not on something that is not useful. So you are at the right place. pay concentration, listen to things carefully, and then proceed. And your approach should be understanding. Your approach should be of understanding. And so as we know, Maga have the blemish of being a Kandantatara. The shloka for Maga is Pitranam Magaha Rudantaha Prastad Pabranshu Avastad. Pitranam Magha is ruled by Pitrus. Pitrus are the forefathers. In Aslesha, the aspect of Pitrus was to take something from you. The aspect of Pitru was the debt that you owe towards them. Right? Your forefathers have given birth to you for the continuation of their lineage. And you have to play an active part in the continuation of the lineage further. Right? Here in Magha, the aspect of ancestors is of giving gifts. So when you give progeny, when you give child to your ancestors, continue the lineage, they actually reward you, they actually gift you with many blessings in life. And one of those blessings, one of most important blessings, are the blessings of the 10th house related to profession, related to career, related to status. Getting my point? Magha comes with the rewarding aspect of Pitrus. The reward that Pitrus give you. Right? Understand it. You know what? The best remedy for the 10th house, the best remedy for profession, the best remedy for career, the best remedy for fame is to pacify your Pitru, pacify your forefathers, pacify your Kuldevka Kuldevi. This is the most important remedy. And I have, I talked to one of the biggest sadhak that I have known. And he told me that, if your 10th lord is Saturn and if you are going to Saturn temple for the, to get good result of the 10th house related to profession, fame, career, etc., it is going to be of no use until and unless you pacify your ancestors. So the gift of recognition, the gift of blessings, the gift of fortune, the gift of support that comes through forefathers is given in Magha, provided the fact that you have a good planet in Magha. When you have a bad planet in Magha, that particular thing can be a problem. So malefic in Magha, sometime the person will think that his family is not supporting him. His parents are not supporting him. Gods are angry. No matter how much hard he is working, he is not getting any recognition. No matter how much hard he is working, he is not getting anything. Getting my point? The sense of dissatisfaction comes if the Magha is afflicted. So Mars in Magha. Let's suppose Mars in Magha. Mars is a malefic. In Magha is the blockage of blessings. So Mars in Magha, the blessings are blocked because you are not able to deal with your anger, deal with your frustration, deal with your energy in a right, appropriate way. Right? If this Mars is the, this Mars is the 10th lord, that will happen in the Cancer ascendant and in the Aquarius ascendant. Right? Now, suppose this Mars is the 10th lord. Then as you overcome your anger, as you overcome your frustration, and as you learn how to manage your energy, in the matters of the 10th house, in the matter of profession, in the matter of fame, in the matter of name, in the matter of lineage, you will get good results. And the two nakshatras, although there are many nakshatras related to Pitrus, but Magha is very important. Any affliction to Magha will make sure that the person suffers on behalf of children. You know, one of the most important house for progeny, one of most important house to be checked for child is 10th house, because that indicates continuation of lineage. No matter how bad is the 10th, how bad is the 5th house, if the 10th house is good, there will be no problem in having lineage, having the children, or at least after some problem, children will be there for sure. The same thing is given by Magha as well, right? So whichever planet is in Magha related to the signification of that planet, you have to be very careful, and you should please your ancestors with that particular signification. So when the Lagna Lord is in Magha, your approach, your personality should be like your ancestors. So if your father is known for his anger, you should also be known for your anger. If the second lord is in Magha, then your source of income and their source of, sorry, your savings and their savings have to be same. If the 11th lord is in Magha, then your source of income and your ancestors' source of income should be the same. Ancestors generally are taken as father and grandfather. Right. So if they are alive, you can be in the same field. Or if they are not alive, you know what they did and be in the same field. That is how the blessings of Magha are supposed to come. Going further, Magha indicates crying. Whichever planet is in Magha, there is a dissatisfaction. There is an uneasiness related to the signification of that planet. Whichever planet is in Magha, you don't get good results of the planet very easily in your life. After much struggle, after much hard work, after much contemplation, the good result of that planet is supposed to come at least once in life. That planet will make you cry very badly. So Venus in Magha or the seventh lord in Magha, at least once in life, you will cry for your mental life. The fifth lord in Magha makes sure that you cry for a child. Cry in front of God, cry in front of ancestors. Asalesha was the anger aspect of ancestors. Magha is the pleased aspect of ancestors, right? Going further, Magha indicates someone who is fallen down. So that is also something important. You know, it is told in astrology that if Saturn is connected to the 10th house, then at least once the person will go in top of their career and will lose everything. Getting my point? The same thing is given by Magha also. Whichever planet is in Magha, you will gain everything related to that planet, and then you have to lose almost everything related to that planet once in life. Getting my point? Should understand it. Okay. You can be on the top of your profession, you can be on the top of your career, but you have to lose it. So going to the top and then falling down is indicated by Magha. Right? For an example, see this chart. This person is having Saturn in Magha. Now simple. What things are indicated by Saturn? Should I tell you the difference between good astrology versus bad astrology? You know the answer. You know the answer, right? And Rupesh will give me the answer. Saturn is the karaka for disease. Okay. How many of you say, okay, Saturn is the karaka for disease, or okay? How many of you say, come on? Okay. Rupesh is not listening to me. So that means, okay. And Saturn remains in one Rashi for 2.5 years. and one rashi will contain 2.5 nakshatra. So in one nakshatra, Saturn is supposed to be 1 year approximately, and one nakshatra will have 4 padas, right? 4 threes are 12. So in one nakshatra pada, Saturn is supposed to be in 3 months, before 3 months. So can you say that, sir, everyone born in this 3 months will have same type of disease? Can you tell me? Do you think it is a good astrology? What is the karaka for Saturn? Prime importance I will give to the house lordship. Because ascendant will change, there 12 ascendants will come in a day, 2.5 hours per ascendant, right? So that's where the difference will come, right? So Saturn is the 7th lord and 8th lord in Magha, right? So this person got married to the cousin daughter of, I don't know what is cousin daughter, but this is how he explained. So this person got married to cousin daughter of a very famous male singer. Very famous male singer, not of yesteryears, but even of today. He got married. How happy he must have been. This is a person from an almost this is a person from a rural area. This is a person from village. He got married to that lady. Very happy. In 3 months of marriage, the lady filed a divorce. Getting my point? In 3 months, the lady filed a divorce and fled. It was the same time when this person gave bribe to get a government job, and the person took the bribe and never gave him a government job also. Added to that, there was alimony for the divorce, right? Went to marry one of the most beautiful, talented type of lady, whatever you say, right? But fell down. And after that, he spent a long time in life being bachelor. After that, he went in relationship with a lady. And then his relationship with that lady is like a swan couple, hanso ka joda. Right? That have been that particular way. So what does it indicate? Getting married to a lady of dreams, a dream for many, right? And then falling down. And then once again going up, right? So this is what is indicated by Magha. And there is something very important with Magha. Magha will never go against Dharma. Magha will never go against religion, right? So despite this person lost his wife, the thing that happened with him was very bad. The thing that happened with him was very heartbreaking. But even after that, this person cried. Like Magha indicates cry, right? So this person cried, yearned, wanted a life partner for a long time. But even in that wait of events for the right thing to happen, he never resorted to bad activities. So Magha is not papakarma. He is not going to do something bad. He is someone who will patiently cry. For an example, I always give this particular example. I will give it once again. When Ramakrishna Paramahansa wanted students, he used to go on the top of the temple where he was working and used to cry. That why students are not coming to me. So the crying is there, but Ramakrishna Paramahansa never gave his advertisement in newspaper that you come join my 5-day shivir. No. Right? So crying is there in Magha, but advertisement or doing something to end that crying is not there in Magha. For this particular reason, I always say Magha as someone who is sobbing silently, someone who is going through a bad phase silently, not being much able to do something with it, right? Magha is indicated by Pitrus. And Pitar, the word indicate the one who drinks the sunlight like water. So Magha needs a lot of emotional work. Magha needs a lot of emotional work. All the rays of sun, they drink like water. And as I have repeatedly told you, that water is linked with emotions, right? So this person is very emotional. This person needs a lot of emotional support. This person needs to be looked like you will. This person need to be looked like you will look at a child. This person needs, you know, like high level of attention. But all the love and all the care is never sufficient for Magha. So Magha person wants a very high level of love and very high level of support and very high level of emotional attention. But he will soak up all the attention and will not be able to revert it back. So Magha person wants a lot of love, but will not be in a habit of reverting that back. So you cannot find a right expression or right result, or rather say right reward when it comes to Magha. Right? Are you getting my point? Pitrus are the one who take care, and that also comes in Magha. So Magha indicates Raj Yuga as well. Whichever planet is in Magha, if that planet is positive, then Magha indicates Raj Yuga. Whichever planet is in Magha, if that planet is positive, you can go in the profession related to that planet, and that will be very prosperous for you. That is how you are supposed to understand Raj Yuga. Right, when a planet, if you have a planet in Rajyoga Nakshatra, that means that planet have a potential to give you professional success, provided the fact that you follow his path. So that is with Magha. Okay. And Magha also indicates things after you die. Right. Magha also indicates thing after you die. So Magha is also very closely related to intuition, closely related to foresight, and closely related to someone being into astrology, someone being and becoming an astrologer. Let me tell you, in classics, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Scorpio, and Aquarius. Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Scorpio, and Aquarius, these signs are told as astrologers. And the nakshatra Magha, Ashlesha, and Satudisha is known as astrology. Pushya also. Pushya, Magha, Ashlesha, Satudisha is known as astrology. Specifically, Satudisha is known as the astrology, right? Good for astrology, good for astrological knowledge, or rather say good for the knowledge to guess things before they are coming and doing suitable and appropriate remedial measures, right? And you know what? Magha indicates a very narrow gate. Magha indicates a very narrow gate. So when Magha starts activating, you are supposed to get rid of many useless things. If you have a very big friend circle, Magha is not going to work for you. When you have a very small friend circle, only then Magha is going to work for you. Right. So for the activation of Magha, you should leave the extra baggage. That's why I was talking about that particular thing in the starting, right? As I always keep on telling in every class, even if I'm talking something in a joking sense, that have something to do. The particular nakshatra or the particular rashi, right? Because when you read with me, I activate that particular rashi. Yes, I'm Brahma. Jokes apart. So that's why I was talking of this particular thing. Okay. So Magha indicates a narrow path, and there can be no baggage in that particular area. right? So whichever planet is in Magha, you have to be alone in the signification of that planet to become really successful, to become really prosperous related to the signification of that planet. Got my point? Extra baggage needs to be left. So if you have a seventh lord in Magha and you want to get married, all the affairs, flings, past things you have to leave and cry in solace for at least 6 months, then you will be able to find the right lady for marriage. So generally, if someone have Magha in the seventh house or seventh lord in Magha or Venus in Magha, I ask them a particular question. That before getting married, were you alone for some time? If they say yes, then I will say your marital life is good. If they say no, then I'm like, okay. Then Magha lady is going to come into your life and this marriage is not going to be very fruitful, right? So this is the way you predict. The real thing is making a serious prediction. You cut onion very speedily is not a prediction, by the way. Coming to the remedies of Magha, before I go with the Pada results of Magha. Remedy of Magha. So you know this indicate ancestors, and as I have already told you, worshipping your ancestors. Worshipping your ancestors is important. Worshipping your Kula Devata is important. Try finding the name of your Kula Devata or Kula Devi and chant the name. Nam Japa have very, like Nam Japa is very strong. Right. Near your birthplace, there should be one temple. At least one temple or any place related to your religion have to be nearby your birthplace. Try visiting that temple, that mosque, that church, that gurudwara once a year at least. Right? And third remedy that I recommend for Magha is to have a cushion in your place of worship. So, you know, whenever like there are two type of temples that you will see. One temple where God is just kept on the floor. Second type of temple is where God is like kept on a cloth or God is kept on something. So for Magha, I will strongly recommend never ever keep God directly on the floor or directly on the temple. Have something below it. So when you place a murti, you put some akshat below it. When you put a yantra, you put a cloth below it. Cloth related to the color of that particular deity. So when you establish a Ganesh yantra, you put a white cloth below it. Then you place the Ganesh yantra, right? So putting something below everything is a remedy for Magha is what I will say, right? The support. So when you are going to sit on a chair, don't just sit on a chair, like try having a cushion. Put that cushion on the chair and then sit. The result for different padas of Magha. So as I told in the starting, that there are classical results for everything as well. Right? So I am telling you the classical result for different padas of Magha. The first pada of Magha, the person will have a thin stomach, a thin waist. The person will be very aggressive in nature. The person will have red nose. This, you know, this particular tip of the nose will be red or will be burnt. Like some fire accident related to the face is indicated. He will have a prominent head. This person will be very courageous. And this person will have a broad chest. Now the results that we are making as per the configuration of Rashi and Navamsha, right? Rajyogas are going to come. So the person is blessed and fortunate in the matters of job or profession. The person should be either in government job or will be in business. The person will be courageous. The person will have red eyes. He will not be very tall. the first pada of Magha is what we are talking about. He will not be very tall and he will be famous. But from the early age of his life, he had to take responsibility of himself and also of his other siblings or relatives, so to say. Right? The person can be lazy. The person will unnecessarily delay things. Generally, he will be opposed by people. There will be opposition from people also. Many people will not support him. Marital life for Magha first pada is not good. Okay. Along with this, this person is aggressive in nature, and whenever he thinks that I have to do this particular thing, whenever he decides to achieve something, he will be able to achieve it. So the first pada of Magha is very good for the achievement. Okay. Going to the second pada of Magha. So what is this? Leo sign and Taurus Navamsh. When Sun and Venus come together, one thing is very certain, that marital life is bad. So Magha second pada, marital life is bad. Then Navamsha goes to the 10th house. Marital life is bad, but the person is famous and successful. The chances of government job is very strong. The person is like very harsh in his speech. The person is not very emotional. Almost someone who is very, you know, like very detached kind of a person, or someone who is very cruel, is indicated by the Magha second pada. Along with this, the person will be spiritual, will not be much interested in physical affairs. There will also be problem in having children. There will also be problem in continuation of the lineage. Along with that, the person will have a balanced approach toward life. He will have good amount of landed properties and vehicles, but will not be able to save money. Day-to-day income will be good, but his wishes and desires will not be easily fulfilled. His face will be very prominent and broad. He will have a square body. Square means like good in length and good in breadth. So he will have a square body. He will have broad eyes. He will have broad chest, long arms and a big nose, right? For the second pada of Magha. The third pada of Magha, person is a born businessman. Third pada of Magha, the person will unnecessarily be endowed with the responsibility of taking care of their siblings. The person will be unnecessarily the person will be endowed to take care of someone which should not be his responsibility at the first place. His mother and father may not have very cordial relationship with him, but his relationship with the siblings of the father, paternal uncle, etc., is very good. Person will generally struggle for progeny, but his wife will be very good, very beautiful, very talented, very learned, and will be very devoted. There can be problem in having children. There can be problem in having progeny. That is okay. Right? And, the person will generally have problems related to stomach, problem related to voice, will not be able to express his thoughts very clearly. He will be generally misunderstood, and even now and then will be indulged in fight. The native will have good hair. He will have long arms. Possibly he will also have very prominent hair on their chest. Their eyes will be very beautiful. they will be fickle minded. They will donate a whole lot of money. That also indicates that if they don't donate, they are supposed to lose a whole lot of money. And they will have an elevated nose, strong and prominent nose. They will have a very, very charming and beautiful physique, will be very fair in complexion, and will have a round neck. And generally the neck, the shoulders are very broad and the neck is not visible. For the third pada of Magha. Coming to the fourth pada of Magha. And after this fourth pada, I'm going to take a particular example. Okay. Coming to the fourth pada of Magha. Fourth pada of Magha is a challenging position. The person will have to settle with a normal job. The job is neither going to give him power nor going to give him fame. But the job will give him multiple ways of income, provided the fact that he is able to cash that. In the profession, there will be strong opposition. In the profession, there will be strong competition, and the person will be able to barely survive. At least for a long part of time, this thing will happen. Right? Going further, it is not good for the authority. Even his own children will disobey him. His own wife will disobey him. The relationship with the children and wife is not very cordial. Despite the fact that there will be no problem in getting children, producing children, and there will be no problem in getting married as well. Right? Just the children and wife have a strong personality, so they may not listen to his advices, but will try to do what they themselves want to do. Right. Going further, the person is like short-tempered, but at the same point of time is timid and will not be able to show his temper very openly. So he may be frustrated on even small things, but will not be able to convey his anger in a good sense. In the starting phase of life, he will be, expressing his anger very frequently, which will cause him many losses. And after that, he will learn the tendency to hide his thoughts, but will become easily irritated. That is, right? The person is fortunate, but the fortune is only after the birth of child. They generally don't live at the place where they are born. There will be change of residence multiple times in their life. The person will be religious. The person will be spiritual. Right, and the person will be specifically endowed with the capacity of making gods happy, which technically means the person is blessed by the gods also. Right, there may be many health problems. If not many health problems, then at least one or two health problems is there throughout the life. That health problem can be very small or very big also. That depends on multiple scenario. Right, at least one property they have to sell on loss, right? Such person will be dark in complexion, but their skin will be very soft and watery, like oily, sorry, not watery, oily. Skin will be oily, complexion will be dark, right? They will have large eyes, black eyes, soft hair, very peculiar, sweet voice. They will have big hands. Big hands mean this palm, right? This palm is big. This is what is true. Whenever we say big hand, don't take it for the length of the hand, right? The length of the hand is proportional to the length of your body. That the palm is talked of whenever we say hand. We are not talking of arms. We are talking of hands, right? Hand is the palm. So big hands, big palm. Prominent big legs, तो सर बड़े सरदारों के और हैं. That is a saying. I'm sorry if I hurt your religious sentiments, but that is a very good saying. Right? That is nothing detrimental. So it is said that सर बड़े सरदारों के और पैर बड़े गवारों के. So that means if you are a Punjabi, you are very intelligent. Punjabis knows how to make money. And if your legs are big, you are gawar. Gawar technically means someone who is not very well versed in how to do things. So generally come as a like simple man who doesn't understand the nuances of the world. And yeah. And his stomach will be a bit prominent. So the person will generally be thin with a prominent stomach, with a like bloated stomach. Is the result for the fourth pada of Magha. So let's take an example. Should we take an example or not? Let's do. So this is a chart. Make predictions. I am using Satavadika Dasha in this chart for unknown reasons. And don't ask me, sir, why not Vibhishaktri, okay? But this is one of the chart that I have calculated the Dasas for. So, I'm using Satavadika Dasha. And in that Satavadika Dasha, the person was in Jupiter Dasha from 1988 to 2008. 20 years, almost. So what should be the result of Magha? So the person is blessed in fortune. The person should be like blessed by his, Jupiter is a good planet. And here is the lord of the first house and the fourth house. So all of the things that we have talked about, let me interpret it, right? Just a few points. I don't remember everything that I told, right? But I'm just going to use the Jupiter in Magha and not other things. So the person is supposed to be blessed by his ancestors. Blessed by his ancestors with regard to education and profession. In that time from 1998 to 2008, if this person was reading, he was doing very good. If this person was learning in school, college, he was doing very good. If he was starting with a business or starting with a job, then also he was doing almost like fairly good. The support of the luck have to be there because it is a good planet, the Lagna Lord and the fourth. It is also indicated that the person was able to invest some money in property, good fourth lord, right? So once again, a blessed ancestors. So person will be able to invest some money in property or at least will be able to buy a vehicle by 2008. In the end, we will get to know how many predictions are right and how many predictions are wrong. But for now, let me just take it in a nutshell. But because it is in the ninth house, despite the person being fortunate, then despite the person being blessed, he cries for his fortune because there are many competitions and many enemies. So despite the, see, he is fortunate from where he have reached. But he cries because people have been unfair with him. Right? These are the few of the things related to Magha. A cheating related to property, etc. must have happened. Or construction of some property may have got stuck because of few reasons or the property can something where you have the property, but you cannot do something on it because you are not living in that area or some other stuff, right? So anything can be there because it is Jupiter. The result is supposed to be good only, right? So you have a property, but you are not able to make it because you don't live here. Or because you think that your child will not want to live there in future, so why to waste time or from that particular property, so leave it. Kind of an approach. And because it is the first pada of Magha, the person is generally short-tempered but balanced and calm. Like should be dark in complexion. He gets easily frustrated but will behave calm, right? And is generally authoritative. And there is no one who can challenge him in his profession. He is well known in his profession, at least in his own area. Because once again, in Navamsha, it goes to Aries. The sign is Leo, the Navamsha is Aries, and the Lord of Leo is exalted Aries, right? So the person is famous, earns well, and his position in his profession cannot be challenged by people, right? these are the things that I will say in a nutshell if I have to illustrate it using a chart, right? And all of these things should happen between 1988 to 2008, okay? So tell me the wrong things the parties are, so that I can say why it is wrong. Otherwise, okay. आज का गड़बड़ मुझे नहीं सुनाई पड़ रहा है कि किसी को नहीं पड़ रहा। आवाज अभी नहीं, नो 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 नो, साउंड इशू, माय स्पीकर इज जस्ट ब्लिंकिंग बीप 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 एंड गिविंग मी नो साउंड एट ऑल। अच्छा त्रिपाठी साहब, यू राइट इन द ग्रुप, लाइक यू राइट इन द ग्रुप और सेंड मी अ पर्सनल मैसेज एंड लेट्स सी, आई विल ट्राई पोस्टिंग द रिजल्ट बाय लाइक द नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट क्लास, राइट? सो यू कैन लाइक गो थ्रू द वीडियो एंड ऑल द प्रेडिक्शंस दैट आई हैव मेड एंड यू कैन मेक अ पॉइंट, आई कैन टेल दिस दिस राइट, दिस दिस रॉन्ग, देन वी विल ट्राई टेकिंग व्हाई राइट व्हाई रॉन्ग, ओके? सो दैट्स इट फॉर मगा एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द नेक्स्ट नक्षत्र नेक्स्ट क्लास, राइट? Thank you for watching the video.
बताया कि वो प्रोफेशन और करियर में उनका आशीर्वाद उस रूप में मिलता है।
हाँ।
वो मुझे दिखा इसलिए मैं क्लियर कर।
ये आपने अच्छा पॉइंट किया कि जैसे मगा इंडिकेट्स द ब्लेसिंग ऑफ एंसेस्टर्स, तो आप बोले वो है उनको जो है कि प्रोफेशन में बहुत अच्छे हैं, तो स्टार्टिंग से ही है। तो व्हेन यू हैव अ प्लान इन मगा, दैट ब्लेसिंग ऑफ एंसेस्टर इज फ्रॉम द स्टार्टिंग। अब until and unless you do something to make them angry, the blessing will remain there. ऐसा।
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Let's meet in the next class, right? Rupesh, I am pretty sure that you understand the point that I am saying, है ना? Mindful.
Sir, tell in English, sir. Simplify in them. I couldn't understand them.